friend. I'm Marcy Farrell from thankfulhomemaker.com, and I'm so glad to get to be with you today. We have a topic that I love to talk about today, and it's productivity. This is a skill set that's not a natural for me. It's something I continually have to work very hard at. I'm a continual learner, and I'm always tweaking and changing and trying new methods to try to simplify my days and make the most of them. We're just turning the calendar as I'm recording this episode. So time management, I know, is one that is always on my list, and maybe it's on yours too. So I'm hoping I can share a few things today that you can learn from or glean from. And if not, just hang with me for a little bit. So it's also a fun time of year because we get to start with a new planner for the year that always excites me, or we turn and we start with a fresh calendar. A quote I love that I want to share with you is from Jonathan Edwards, and it's a great one to start the new year off with. He said, "Resolved never to lose one moment of time, but to improve it in the most profitable way I possibly can." So I don't know about you, but I want to keep improving my productivity and making the best use of my time. And one of the best teachers has been the Lord, and the example given to me on the importance on making the most of our days that are found in the scriptures. So Psalm 90 verse 12 tells us, "So teach us to number our days that we may get a heart of wisdom." So when I think that through, I think, how do I productively plan my days with my eyes on eternity? Because time is precious, and I want to use the time the Lord has given me well. Our life is a vapor, and our hope is we always live with eternity in view. And another very popular verse we all know is from Ephesians, actually two verses there, from chapter 5, verses 15 to 16. They tell us, "Look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of time because the days are evil." I'm reminded that nothing in life is trivial, but everything matters, right? Everything, even how we spend our time. The word "carefully" there in that verse is in the present imperative, which means that we continually pay attention to how we're walking. It's continual. So how do we walk as wise and not unwise? And in those verses in Ephesians, it laid it out clearly by making the best use of our time. So I desire to make the best use of my time because every second is a gift from the Lord. So whether we're planning dinner, cleaning, running errands, attending church, ministering to someone, it usually comes about because we've taken the time to plan our days well. And I wanted to share some of the really simple tools. Most of them are free. They're actually pretty much, I think all of them have freebies. Simple tools I use. Some are apps, some are simple paper and pen methods that have helped me to manage my time of being a wife and a homemaker and a mother, now a grandmother, for over going on almost 35 years now that I say that. I continue to tweak them, and they change over various seasons of my life. And again, they may not all work for you the way they do for me, because we all tend to do things differently. But this is an area that I hope to spur you on, that if you'd like a little bit of help in or some other ideas, that I pray you'll grab a little bit from this. So I'm going through them briefly. I'm not elaborating. I have additional posts and podcast episodes and probably some other videos on these that I will link to in the main notes at thankfulhomemaker.com if you want a little more information. But I'm going to get a little tidbit for each one today and just kind of walk through them. And then also, friends, if you're enjoying the channel and content, please make sure you subscribe if you haven't yet. I'd love you to be a subscriber. That way you don't miss a new video when it comes out. And if you give it a thumbs up at the end, that would be a sweet blessing, especially if you enjoyed the video and it was a help to you. So here they are, my top 5 productivity tips. First one is simple. Plan your days, right? It seems simple, but how many times do we not do it? There's many times a week goes by and I didn't plan and I didn't think ahead and I didn't look at the week. And those are probably not my best weeks. So when I'm in a good mode, I usually do my planning on Sunday evenings. And this is nothing complicated. I usually just sit down with my planner. I'm using very simply the Homemaker's Friend Daily Planner. As I'm writing this, I believe it's only $15.99. Great purchase. I'll put the link below. It's really simple. I have a walkthrough on it. I can, if you look at my videos, or I'll try to share that too. But very simply, I use that planner and I use the Google Calendar app. And then I start plugging in, appointments and things like that for the week, what I have to do. I can kind of look at my previous week to see what didn't get done or what transferred over. And it's as simple as that. One other thought as I'm sharing that, and again, I have more posts on these I will share with you in the show notes, but if you want to dig a little deeper, but this is kind of a really good one that I want to talk about, is if you can get your husband to sit with you and plan your weeks together, do that. My husband and I, we use a Google shared calendar, and I appreciate being able to see his schedule. It helps us to both see what's going on in each other's lives that week so we can kind of plan ahead. It probably takes us less than 5 minutes. I don't even know if it takes that long sometimes, but it's worth every minute of it. We also, in Google Calendar, we use a shared calendar for he and I, but that same shared calendar also gets used with our adult children and with my father-in-law. He uses it too, so everybody can see what everybody's doing, and I really like that. So that's number one, plan your days. And the second one goes along with this. This is called the daily to-do list. That's what I call it. But it comes along with my planner. I do use an app for this. I've talked about it before. It's an app called TickTick. And TickTick is just a basic kind of to-do app. But it keeps a to-do list of my tasks that I plug in from the planner. And what I love about that one is it also shows me my calendar. So when I open TickTick for the day and I look at it, it has my to-do list tasks and my calendar right on it, so I can see that. There's also a habit tracker in there that I've not really used, but some people would love that. It's not one of my favorite things necessarily. My to-do list in TickTick kind of becomes my brain dump too, because I usually have my phone on me or my iPad. If I'm out and about and I think of something I need to add to my list, I can dump it in there. It goes in the inbox in TickTick, and then I can schedule it and then work it through in my planner. So that works out great. In TickTick, I color code the tasks to prioritize them. And when I say that, I really just use red. So every day I pick 3 tasks and I highlight them in red. That's the high priority level in TickTick. And the rest of them usually stay uncoded for me. I'm very simple and basic with my tech use. I know a lot of people would get into all the different colors, and I'm just like, hey, today I need to focus on these 3 things, and these are to my top priorities. And the other ones, if they happen, they happen. So it's really a helpful tool to help you work through your day with a productive flow, but you don't need a TickTick app. You can use a 3x5 card or a sticky note. It's, you know, nothing big. And that way you can just see at a glance what you need to accomplish next. So I know the to-do list, but I'll take it from my planner. I'll look at my planner. I'll look what's on that day. And I just love to have it somewhere separate and with me mobile if I don't have my planner with me. So that's why I love the TickTick app or using a 3x5 card, because I can take it with me on the go. If you're a paper and plan kind of gal, I do have a freebie at the blog, and it's called a daily docket. It's pretty functional. It's very simple. It's very pretty. I think it's pretty. I love the colors on it. But it has space in it to write your top 3 of the day. It has just a regular to-do list. It's got a place to put prayer or scripture for the day, something maybe you're meditating on, you need to pray about. You can separate your day into morning, afternoon, evening. It's got notes to just, you know, kind of do a brain dump with other items that pop up. You have a place for your what's for dinner. And then the top just says the date, if you want to track your water, if you exercised, and then check off your morning and evening routine. So that's kind of it. But you can get it at the blog. It's free for blog subscribers. Blog subscribers obviously are free. I have a free library of printables there for when you subscribe to the blog. I don't email a whole lot at the blog. It's just when a new post or an episode comes up. So that's another benefit. If you're an email subscriber to my blog, you get access to the free library of printables, but you also know when I put a post out, because it'll come in your email. And then I do send out a monthly newsletter for subscribers. Well, I'll throw some favorite links or things I came across in, and maybe a brief devotional. Totally free. I don't know why you're not signed up already. I'm not sure what you're waiting for, but go sign up. I'm going to put the link below the video here, and it'll be in the main show notes too. But when you do that, then you'll get access to the library, and you can check out some of the free printables there. I'm still on the to-do list. One more note on my TickTick app. I do check TickTick. I wish I had my phone here to show it to you, and I don't. TickTick before, it's hard to say that. It's like a tongue twister. I do check it before bed at night. And then I get it all set up for the next day. So I'll just kind of look through and just, you know, maybe there's junk in my inbox that I didn't sort through. And I can go, you know what, I can do that tomorrow. I can't do that tomorrow. I can do that Thursday. I'll just move things around. It's just part of my evening routine. So, and that moves me into my next productivity tips. So we have planning your days, putting together your to-do list for the day, and now it's morning and evening routines. And these two routines have been a game changer for me over the years. I've shared before, I brought them in from Fly Lady, I've tweaked them and made them my own, but most of my tasks for the day are taken care of in these two simple routines. If you haven't tried this one yet, or these two yet, I should say, at least start with a morning routine. Start there. And maybe you just start with three simple items. Maybe you start with simple on your list that you get up and you have a daily quiet time with the Lord. You do breakfast and you shower. Maybe that's all your morning routine is. And again, because these are staples, I have multiple posts and podcasts. And one top one to listen to if you've not started would be implementing a realistic morning routine. And I do have a video on that one here that you can find, and I'll link to that too. So my morning routine right now consists of coffee. Always coffee first. That's key, right? But it's time in the Word and prayer, and I have a free download on what I do with my time in the Lord. And again, it's at the free library. So you can grab that download. Not necessary, but it just kind of guides you through. And my printer's looking kind of weird, so if it looks weird, it's just because my printer's a little glitchy today. So I need my hubby to look at that for me. I don't know what to do with it when the printer gets goofy. I'm not sure. So my time with the Lord is next. Then I would have exercise and shower, make my bed. When I shower, I make the bed and I tidy the bathroom at the same time and just get done up there. We'll have breakfast. I'll do the dishes in the morning. That's the time I kind of check my planner, and I'm trying to think this through in my memory. You would think I would have this. I will check at that point what's for dinner, and then I just kind of start my day. I'm sure I missed something, but that's the basic of it. So the next part of that brings me to number four, which is meal plan. So we've got plan your days, we've got your to-do list, we've got set some routines in at least your morning, if nowhere else. Just get a regular morning routine, something you do every day. And then the fourth one is to meal plan. And I know, friends, I hammer this one all the time on the blog and the podcast and now here on YouTube, but I cannot stress how helpful it is in saving time and money. It is huge. I don't care how you do it, do it. I don't even care if you just get up in the morning and think about what you're going to eat that day and you write it down. At least then the rest of the day, you don't have to think about it. And if you need to pick something up for dinner, or at least you know early in the day instead of at 5:30 when you're getting ready to cook dinner. So good stuff. I have posts. I have a free PDF meal planner. And actually, here, let me show you. I have this one, which my hubby made for me quite a few years ago. And this one didn't print well, but I have this one that's going to, actually, it's going to go up with this post today. So it'll be there for you too. And again, it'll be at the show notes in the free library. But again, I also have an online course for menu planning if you want to dig a little bit deeper. It's video driven. There's a whole printable pack to put your own personal menu planner together, which would be meals that you love to cook and your family loves to eat. It's not all this other junk that you're pulling from cookbooks that nobody likes or it's too crazy to make. It's simple meals that you love to cook and your family loves to eat. And that's what I love about my menu planning system. I've tweaked it to make it work for my family and for me. I'm a pretty simple cook, so I'm not the one that's probably cooking that item that has like 27 ingredients. That's not gonna be me. I'm gonna be looking for those 5 ingredient or less items. So let's go. You're gonna plan your days, however that looks, with your planner or your calendar or just good old pen and paper. You're gonna make your to-do list. You're gonna set up at least a morning routine. You're gonna at least plan your meals, at least for that day. And the last one, this is truly the most important, friend. Number 5 is pray. This should be number 1 on the list, but it's the one that I wanted both of us to remember the most here. So before you sit with your planner, pray. Ask the Lord to help you make the most of the time. Pray about people you can minister to this upcoming week through phone calls or cards or visits. Pray about how you can minister to your own family and work these areas that the Holy Spirit brings to your mind into your weekly and then daily schedule. Is there a neighbor who needs a meal? Can you work that in your meal planning for the week? Does your husband need a sweet love letter from you this week? You know, it's okay to put that on your to-do list. That's not a wrong thing to do. Can your child use a little help cleaning their room? And then also this part of it, repent of areas where you've not been using your time wisely and ask the Lord to help you be more productive and make the changes needed. Albert Mohler said, we cannot add time. We can only exercise stewardship over the time we are given. And one last important reminder here, the moment we take our eyes off ourselves and we put them on the Lord, that's where we begin to make the best use of our time. It starts there because the Lord, He is our ultimate planner. So let's allow His schedule to plan our days. He appoints our portion each day. These are great tools I've talked about to help implement your day-to-day life, and there's nothing new I've shared. These are all, everybody's using these type of tools in different ways. But I want us to always remember at the end here that our God is sovereign, and we may need to adjust our plan to His. Proverbs 16:9 says, the heart of man plans his ways, but the Lord establishes his steps. Because what do I end with? Because Jesus is enough always. I am so thankful for you, my friend, and I pray you have a very blessed week.